Hello everyone, I am Anagha Bhosle and I along with my team members Neel Deshpande and Ruchi Turunkar have implemented the a priori algorithm for K frequent item set. So how does it work? We have created a basic flowchart and I will go through it in order to give an overview of our program. So we have a data pre-processing job that will process the data such that the data into a data that is acceptable to the one-pass a priori job. The one-pass a priori job is a implementation that is similar to a word count problem, wherein we count the number of occurrences of the item set such that the support for which is greater than the minimum support. After that, we have the candidates and set generation job. And in this job, we use the input as the output from the output of the frequent item set from the previous pass. And this implementation is basically a reduced side self join, and which will generate all the possible combinations. And after this, we have the pruning job and the post-processing job, which is a filter that will filter the candidates for which the subsets of the candidates does not occur in the output of the frequent item set in the previous pass. Now this output will then be consumed by our compute LK job, which will determine, that is, it will check the pruned candidate set and check the number of time it occurs into the transaction, original transaction, and output only those for which the support is greater than the minimum support. And this will continue until the iteration K. Now let's talk about the challenges that we encountered for the candidate set generation. So initially our intuition for the candidate set generation was to have the candidate set inside the memory. But while doing that, we were facing memory issues, and the first approach that we had in mind was to use optimized data structure like a prefix tree. And after using that as well, we were able to process the data. It took some time, but ultimately for a large data set, it resulted into memory issues again. So we changed our approach, and the second approach that we had and currently have implemented is to have the candidate set generation as a separate job so that the problem is solved in a distributed environment. And this implementation is the reduced side join, self join. And this gave a significant improvised result. And thus we thought of moving ahead with this particular approach. So that's it from my end. And my team members will now explain the challenges that we encountered in the other task. And that's all from my end. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. So for pruning and post-processing, we essentially did two different MapReduce jobs. The first MapReduce job looks at the previous frequent item sets, say which were K-sized, and it also looks at the if the previous frequent item sets were K-1 sized, it also looks at candidates of size K which are generated in the step just before this. And we perform a reduced side join to just match all the candidates and confirm that if a candidate is K-sized, we confirm that all of its K-1 sized subsets are actually a part of the previous frequent item set output. This is done by two different mappers. One of them reads the candidate file, the other one reads the output from the previous iteration, and there's a simple reduced side join that happens. So we actually came up to this approach after trying a couple of other stuff. We tried to keep one of them in memory and just generate, we tried to keep the output from the previous iteration in memory and just generate and make sure that all of the subsets from this candidate occur in that output by just looking it up, but it wasn't efficient because the previous output file can be much larger than memory. So that's why we chose to do a reduced side join as opposed to just keeping one of the files in memory. And then at the end of the first job, there is one line for each occurrence of each subset in a candidate set. So then we just need to make sure the post-processing job just makes sure that say for a particular candidate, it just makes sure that if it had four subsets which are emitted, it just makes sure that all four of those have been matched, so that no subset belonging to a particular candidate is infrequent. That's why the post-processing job is necessary. Yeah, that's post-processing. And after this, we'll talk about the final compute LK job. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. I'm Ruchi Torunkar. I'll be going over the implementation and challenges encountered during compute LK job. As my teammate explained, compute LK job considers the candidates generated in that pass and looks up those candidates in the original transaction set to identify their count. If the count is above the minimum support, the candidate set is considered frequent. Now, to implement this job, we tried several strategies like keeping the candidate set in memory, keeping transaction in memory. It went well for the smaller data set, but as the size of the data set increased, it turned out to be not scalable. Then later we identified the approach wherein we used a reduced side join. Here we implemented two mappers, one for transaction data set and the other for the candidate data set. So the reduced side join then aggregates the occurrences of candidates in the transaction and emit each such candidate only if its support satisfies the minimum threshold. So while implementing the compute LK, we still believe that there is a bottleneck in the while computing the subsets of the transaction set. And as the number of iterations increase, to compute the subset of a given transaction becomes a bottleneck. We tried several approaches to improve that, but given the time constraint, unfortunately, we couldn't actually fix it. But we believe that if we had figured out, a better approach to generate the subset, it would have been much faster. So that is it from me. Thank you.
Hi again. So for speed up, as you can see, we tried to run the job for the large data set on cluster size of 2, 5, 7, and 10 machines. And you can see that for 2, it took around 1 hour, 11 minutes. Then for 5 machines, it took 46. It gradually decreased from there. So it was what we were expecting. Maybe it wasn't as well as we were expecting when it went to 10 machines, because maybe there wasn't enough stuff to parallelize beyond 7 machines, but we do see a gradual decrease in the time required. And talking about scale up, it was actually, we couldn't like fix the time, fix the runtime for two different inputs of data. We couldn't make the large data set run just for 8 minutes. So we just tried to like run two different data sets as input on the same job, and these are the times that we got. Which I also think are consistent with the speed up values. We had a lot of fun with this project. We were able to set up like an entire implementation that ingests market analysis data and generates case size frequent item sets. We did not keep any file completely in memory at all, so that we do have scalability as we increase the number of machines. And we did run into a couple of problems that we didn't anticipate before. We thought it would be easy, but it wasn't. It was a challenge to make it work on a distributed environment, but we were able to do that with the exception of the one bottleneck. With the exception of the one bottleneck about generating subsets for a transaction. So given a transaction, we are asking subsets of size K. And that is actually an expensive operation. So sometimes like it always takes too long. So yeah, we didn't have enough time to figure that out, because anyways, it was like an algorithms problem. We definitely would like to give more thought to it, but we couldn't find enough time to do it right now. But yeah, other than that, I think we were able to do everything and parallelize all the stuff that was necessary to be parallelized. And yeah, that's it. That's the presentation for our project. We had a lot of fun, and thank you so much for giving us this opportunity and this idea.